to introduce you to my husband, and his name is Kofi Asan. Kofi is a network engineer, IT specialist. He's a jack of all trades. He does pretty much, he does a lot of things. He's from Ghana, Africa, and tell us some more about yourself, Kofi.
So, as you heard, I'm originally from Ghana, from the central region that is one of the best tourist attractions when anyone comes to visit Ghana. So, that is basically it.
Yes.
From Ghana.
Okay, okay. So, how long have you been here in the United States?
4 years going five.
So I got it straight off the boat, fresh and hot. So tell me more as far as what are some vast differences you noticed coming here to America? Had you ever been outside of your country prior to coming to America?
Yes, so before coming to the United States, I have been to a couple of European countries. I have been to couple of African countries before coming here.
What are some European countries you visited?
I've been to Amsterdam, I've been to Germany, been to what's it called? Turkey.
Turkey, oh wow. Interesting. So tell me, what were some vast differences that you realized when you first got here to America versus home, you know? What was something that stuck out in your mind, like, wow?
Okay, so back home, what we used to see, what the U.S. is all about, is an example when we watch Bill Cosby. That is what we see the United States is all about. When you watch, what's it called?
Family
Matters? No. The show that you watch?
Which one?
The detective show.
Oh, SVU. Law and Order.
If you watch Law and Order, that's what you see. The skyscrapers, the fast life, everyone moving about here and there. That's what you see. So that is what is being shown to us, so that's what we believe when we expect to see when we get here. But an example, when I touched down first in U.S. airport in D.C., I did not see any skyscrapers. So I was wondering, like, what's this place? Then my second touchdown, that's DFW, still no skyscrapers. So then reality kicks in. What is being shown to you on TV is not exactly what it is here.
Okay, okay. So what about as far as race relation wise, what are some vast differences that you saw as far as African American people being interpreted on television? You said that you saw the Cosby Show, so is it interpreted as like everybody, all the black people here grew up like the Cosbys, or what was something that you saw there and then you got here when you saw it firsthand, and how did that, you know, really change your view?
So in coming here, what we saw in pertaining to black people was, example, Cosby Show. The show 227.
Yeah, 227.
We watched that one too. We watched Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Mm-hmm. So we see all these, and apart from the shows, we see all these black people in sports. NBA. NBA is also huge in Ghana. I would say huge, but it's something that is being watched. Mm-hmm. So this is what we see of black people back home. And when I got here, initially, I didn't have my work permit. So I had to work in a factory and all that. And notice that most of the black people in all those factories and all that are 80% ex-convicts. Simply because why? Because they are ex-convicts, they can't find a job.
Right.
And these are one of the main places they can find jobs. And that is our first encounter with black people in America at our workplaces. So then someone who is an ex-convict, he's been through the mill in society, through the thick and thin and all that. And that is our first interaction, and that also forms a different picture altogether. When I came first, I met one or two people who came before me, and what they told me was, look out for these black people. They're lazy, they don't want to work, they just want to get paid and go spend their money.
So has that been your experience with all black people that you've come in contact with? Like, that they're lazy, they just want to get paid? Because I've heard that expression a lot, like, that we're the lost children and we have it so easy, and you know what I'm saying? We're in a land where, you know, there's electricity and hot water and, you know, constant electricity and hot water and things of that nature, and we're spoiled, and we should just get over the fact of racism and not be hung up on this thing.
Okay, so I will paint a picture for you in three different worlds. That is example, like my brothers in Nigeria, we in Ghana, and black Americans in the United States. Start with Nigeria. They basically have power outages about, you have power probably once or twice in a week. They basically just don't have power. Some don't even have it at all. If you have to get power, you must have a generator to produce power for you. So if you don't have power, that is it. You don't get it. That is one world. In Ghana, yes, we have power issues. We get power outages probably an hour or two in a week.
Oh.
Or a couple of hours in a week. And when Nigerians come to Ghana, they see it as, wow, you guys have it all. You guys have power, you have water and all that, and why are you guys complaining? Because I went to school with a lot of Nigerians in my school. And one time there was this scandal about this dude that did some kind of money scam on people, and people were complaining. And they were like, okay, how much is the money? So-and-so amount of money. It was like, why are you guys complaining? It's nothing.
It's small.
Back home in Nigeria, a whole governor would take a whole state's budget and take it home. And no one's complaining.
Okay.
And you have this little amount of money that someone spends, and it's all over the news. You get it? So that is two different worlds. Now, when I can speak for Ghanaians because I'm Ghanaian. when we come here, there is power. There is, I had to boil hot water on a gas stove to bath in the morning. Mm-hmm. Now when you open the tap, there is hot water flowing on you. Mm-hmm. There is AC. I never slept in the AC my whole life. Unless when I travel outside the country and in hotels, there's AC. I can buy a car when I want to. I can purchase anything that I want to.
With credit.
Uh-huh. You understand? The system has been set up. So when we come into the system and we see, I came into the system with nothing. With my 10 fingers. And if I come into the system and I am able to get a family, get a job, acquire all this stuff, and I look at you, who has been here all your life, then most Africans begin to rethink and be like,
You stop?
Most Africans begin to rethink and be like, okay, you lazy. Because if you're not making anything for yourself, then you lazy. Mm-hmm. Yes, I have come across people in my various workplaces before I got my work permit. Till now that I have my work permit, I have come across all works of black people. Now, most of the ones that they come across, you have been into the system, and you come out. They do not expect anything from the system. So they just live day by day. That is my own viewpoint. They just want to live day by day, because probably I met one guy. He said he was his own small scale contractor. He went into the system due to some kind of domestic violence. After that, no one wants to employ him. So then, he was virtually doing well for himself. And after that, he just lived day by day. You know, and most of these, so as I said, the ones that I came to meet and I spoke to when I came, that told me that, hey, look out for these black people, they're lazy, most of them have not been in an environment with someone like your uncle. Mm-hmm. Because he doesn't work in a factory. Mm-hmm. This is a person who takes care of his family. Wake up and go to work. That's a different scenario altogether. But there are those that they come to work Monday, get paid, Tuesday, get paid, Wednesday, get paid, Thursday, get paid, Friday, get paid, Saturday, you can't find them. Because that 5-day week money, they went to blow it Saturday, got drunk.
We call it lack of priority.
And can't show up at work.
Okay. So I got another question for you. Did you think, like, when you were growing up, or, you know, ever, like, did you think that you would marry an African American?
No. No one can say who your significant other will be. Mm-hmm. But when I was coming here, the main reason why most of us migrate from Africa and come here is to better our lives, because